Now, let's look at the example 10a in your lecture note. Solve the absolute x minus 3 greater than or equals to absolute 2x plus 5. Since we have two modulus, it means that we will use grading box side method. From the previous video, we know that absolute value of x can be written as square root of x squared. So, when we square the modulus, it will give us only x squared. By applying this, absolute value x minus 3 squared will be x minus 3 squared, and absolute value of 2x plus 5 squared will be 2x plus 5 squared. Expand this quadratic expression will give me x squared minus 6x plus 9 greater than or equals to 4x squared plus 20x plus 25. In order to solve this quadratic inequality, bring 4x squared plus 20x plus 25 to the left hand side and simplify it, and it will give me minus 3x squared minus 26x minus 16 greater than or equals to 0. In order to factorize the quadratic inequality, we must make sure the coefficient of x squared be positive. So, multiply the quadratic inequality by minus 1 and will give me positive 3x squared plus 26x plus 16 less than equals to 0. By factorization, I will get 3x plus 2 times x plus 8 less than equals to 0. Let 3x plus 2 times x plus 8 equals to 0, which gives the roots of x equals to minus 2 over 3 and s is equals to minus 8. Then, using table of sign to find the range value of x that satisfied the inequality. The first column is, write down the expression we want to test. The second column is, the value of x takes when the factors are equals to 0 and put in order. So we want to check if x is in the range of minus infinity to minus 8, or minus 8 to minus 2 over 3, or minus 2 over 3 to infinity. Then, write down the test value for each interval. Any value that lies between minus infinity and minus 8 is minus 9. Any values that lies between minus 8 and minus 2 over 3 is minus 5. And values that lies between minus 2 over 3 to infinity is 6. Then, we test this test value into 3x plus 2 and x plus 8. So, we have negative, negative, positive, negative, positive, positive, negative and negative will give positive, negative times positive will give negative, positive times positive will give positive. We want to find range value of x that makes the quadratic inequality less than 0. So we can say that x is between minus 8 and minus 2 over 3 inclusive.